Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's spend a few minutes discussing a perhaps unexpected impact of fragment-based drug discovery. Library screening is a very common way to find active compounds at the start of a drug discovery campaign. Traditionally, a big compound library could include a million or even multiple millions of molecules. If you have a bigger library, then you are more likely to find active compounds that can eventually lead to a clinical compound and perhaps a drug. Who has massive research libraries? Large drug companies tend to have massive libraries based off decades of research. Therefore, traditional screening approaches are much more feasible for large pharma rather than small biotech companies and labs in academia. Fragment libraries are very different. A fragment library of just 2 to 3,000 compounds is estimated to be adequate to sample fragment space for initiation of a screening campaign. Having a 2,000 or 3,000 molecule library is much easier than potentially millions of compounds. In fact, there are CROs, contract research organizations, that maintain fragment collections and provide companies access to these libraries for screening. Fragment-based drug discovery is therefore a method of opening the practice of drug discovery, at least early drug discovery, beyond just major pharma. This democratization of drug discovery through fragment-based methods allows more ideas to be explored at smaller costs, with the end result of perhaps satisfying more unmet medical needs for patients. That was a very brief discussion of some of the advantages of fragment-based drug discovery toward enabling more researchers to engage in early drug research. Take care.